All right, so good morning. Welcome to Live with Joy. Good morning, people virtually coming on. They'll come on in just a few moments. Today, as you can see, we have no equipment. We're going to be doing cardio today. Low impact, high impact, or low intensity, high intensity. But for our purposes out here where we're kind of wet, we might wind up keeping it low intensity or low impact, okay? I'll give you those options, but you're going to have to see what you feel comfortable with. So at home, same thing. We're doing all cardio, no equipment. Low impact, or low intensity, high intensity. So one of our moves is low, and one is high, okay? You can take that as low or as high as you need to. Of course, I'll give you options as we are going through and do what you feel comfortable. And again, everybody here, do what feels comfortable because obviously you're a little bit wet on the ground, so make sure that you feel solid and feel comfortable in the movement that you are doing, okay? So based on that, we're just gonna get started with our warm-up. And by the way, today is our 150th Live with Joy class, so we're really moving through these classes. It's amazing, right? Since March, it's like 7 months. So, can't believe that here we are, 150. March it out. Let's stand up nice and tall, get those shoulders down, and we're trying to engage that center. I'm just gonna lower this a little bit. Keep marching. Right and left. Good. March it out. 8, 7, 6, 5. Let's go 4, 3, 2, and heel across. Little push. Let's go 8 more here. right where you are. That's going to start to get that heart rate up. And every circuit, we're going to progress, making it a little bit harder, okay? So first thing you want to do is just lift those heels and kind of bounce on the balls of the feet. Or you can take that, those toes off of that floor to make it a little bit more intense if you want to. But we're keeping it low intense for that first move. So you're not trying to make any big big jumps. Just a little bounce on the balls of the feet. Moves a little more intense, trying to get those fast feet. Just bouncing. And we got 30 seconds of every exercise, four times each. Same thing we've been doing all week with our format. Good. Last two. And last one. Now hold. You got 5 seconds to get set and a little more high intensity. Use those arms right here. And you want to plant your chest and your face off of the balls of those feet right there. And that's going to start to get that intensity up. To a march if you need to, okay, so you can make that lower intense if you need to. It doesn't have to be a high intense move. Good, make sure you're breathing, keeping yourself right in that position, and again, trying to do that cardio today. It's all about elevating that cardio today. Last two, and stop. Good, ground your feet, and get ready to bounce it on the toes, or again, you can even take that jump off the floor. Take a moment and get ready for that more high intense. Right in place, two and one. Fast feet right here. Good. Set number two. Good. And not high knees. You're not trying to drive the knees up. You're working on the balls of the feet. Little running in place right here. Got small movement, but a more intense movement with that run. Good, working on speed, two, and stop. Good, round those feet, and get ready to, again, bounce off those heels. And if you want to make it a little more intense, you can come off of that floor with that jump. Otherwise, right here, just working off the balls of the feet, and popping those heels up. Nice soft knees right here. And at any point, if any of the cardio work is too much, just simply march in place, guys, so you're ready to come back into those exercises, okay? And you build that strength. Last two, and stop. Get ready for more intense. Running with those fast feet in two, and one. And again, use those arms for more intensity. The more you move those arms, the more intense that move is going to be. Good, breathe through. You have one more set coming up. Good, make sure you're breathing through it. Keep that good posture. Don't sink into it. Keep that chest open. Last two, and stop. One more set, guys. Working on the heels right here. Lifting and bouncing those heels up. Off those toes if you want to make it a little more intense. Again, up to you. So every time with those four sets, you're going to start at a greater intensity level. After that high intense move, and then down to that low intense. So we're kind of bringing that intensity up and down today, where you can. And we are also working on building that intensity each circuit. Good, bounce off those heels. Last two, and stop. One more time, get rid of those fast feet. In two, and one. Good. Nice job. Get that last one in. Come on up. Get your feet in a position you feel comfortable. Heels to toes or that jump squat. Right here. Again, if you want to really power through it, make it high impact, you're jumping or you're just coming to the toes or you're just squatting it down and up without coming to the toes. Again, whatever feels right for you for that move and where you're at. Use those arms for more intensity. Go on to less intensity. And that goes for every move. Good. Get that last one in. And breathe. Take a moment. Get set in your squat position. And alternate that step back right here. Lengthen it out. Lengthen those arms. And lengthen those legs in the opposite direction. The lower you go, of course, my harder to be on those legs. Higher you go, less. So take it where you need to. Up higher, down low. Ready, that last one in. Ground your feet wherever you want for those heels to toes. Get set. And again, use those arms for more intensity. More higher impact jumping. But again, you don't have to. Right here is fine. Just regular squats are fine. Getting all those muscles involved. Kicking up onto those toes. If you can, we'll give you more intensity and activate more muscles and joints to move. 10 seconds. One more set of each left. Good, last one. And we got one more set, guys. Hang in there. Ready? Go down to where you feel comfortable. Step it back. This is your lower intense move. So almost trying to catch your breath a little bit here. But of course, that intensity is still going to be up higher than it was from when you started this circuit. Full break is coming up. So I do one more set of each, guys. So hang in there. Lengthen out those arms. Lengthen out that leg behind you. Get your feet set in position, heels to toes, jumps, regular squats, right here. Power up with high impact, power up with higher intensity to the toes. Just do those squats, keeping it a little bit lower intense, okay? Lose the arms for less intensity, add the arms for more intensity. You guys got it, hang in there. You got 13 seconds left to go. Come on, you got it, guys. Hang in there. And breathe. Last two. And one. Good. Stop and get some water. And then you guys will watch me. All right, we're going for single side lunge and reach. This is your low impact move. Step and reach. Step and reach. Make it a small move. Single side. And then high impact driving the knees up. Here we go lower. Impact's lower intensity, okay? But that first move is where you want to be. Lower intensity, we'll switch sides with each one. Okay, so that first move, we're going to start with that left foot holding you in position, and that right foot stepping back as you reach the inside of that foot. Go for it, guys. 30 seconds on that clock. So think about getting as low as you can. But again, it can be simple up to one leg. Get low, so you got power in those legs to step, work up from one foot to the other. Thank you. here. If the arms are too much, just focus on the legs. This will create more intensity in that row and start to move. Side to side with that moving squat. You can step in, tap it side to side. stop bending and extending. I'm moving those arms as I squat and as I come back up. Good. Give yourself room. Get down. Whatever direction you have room, 2 walks and back. Lateral walks, 2 steps. Obviously, the more you bend into it, the more you're going to work with the quads, the hamstrings, and the glutes, and even through those hips. But you can come up high, you can be even straight, and just do a side walk if you need to without bent knees. Good. Get yourself in a place where you feel comfortable. Again, level one, tapping it out, squatting for that moving squat, or higher impact, jumping, jack squats. I will move through the squats side to side here. I'll go with level 2 with you guys. Thank you. More seconds. Good, that last one in. Come on up. Now turn those toes out. Option one, just pulse it. Option two, pop up on the toes or just make a bigger movement. Option three is your higher impact where you pop completely off the ground. Okay? So you decide. I'm going to go and pop it up on the toes, not off the floor. But again, at any point, just keep the toes down. Work those pliés. Just keep that little pulse it to really get energy into those inner thighs. Good. Bring it up. Now turn the toes in a little bit. And then start to get your little movement. And then start to make it bigger if you can. Just bring it up and down. Pop it up on those toes. Or higher impact. Popping off of that floor. Find what works for you. Popping up on the toes too much. Just come up and down. See how fast you can do it without turning through the knees. Make sure you're still staying safe in those joints. Good. Last one. Good, turn the toes in a little bit. Again, find what feels comfortable. Start moving, start reaching, and then start finding that range. Thank you. One more. Inhale up. And exhale. Keep those legs out wide. Take those hands on those sides. Let's control the flat back and hold. Round it up halfway. Stretch that spine. Release that tension. And then take a flat back down. And roll it all the way up. Round that hips come across. And once you come up, fold those shoulders back. All right, ready to take that left foot forward, right knee back, press the left knee to the ground, take the right arm across that chest, and press it in. Bring that arm up the back, reach down the back, and press back. Awesome week, guys. If you're willing to unleash, we start at the upper body, push muscles, pull muscles on Tuesday. Wednesday, we had lower body leg day, grab that wrist. Yesterday, first one, we had core. Release, interlock behind the back, open up that chest, squeeze and retract those shoulder blades back. And release, stepping onto the ball of the foot, push those hips forward, squeeze that glute muscle, open up that hip in front. And again, you can stay here with that foot down, or you can grab only if you keep balance. If not, you're staying right here, I'll stay here with you guys. Grab if you can. And then release that foot and bring that heel to the front. Reach down towards those toes, lengthening out the back of that leg. And slide it up. Let's get that right foot forward, left foot back. Press and lengthen that heel to the ground. And then take that left arm across that chest and press it in. Same arms coming up and back. Reach down the back and press back. Lengthening on that ground, the wrist and fall. And rise up, release, interlock behind the back, open up the chest, squeeze and retract those shoulder blades back. And release, stepping onto the ball of the foot, press those hips forward, squeeze that glute muscle, open up those hips in front. And again, if you can balance, go ahead and grab that foot. If not, just keep the ball of the foot on the floor and keep pressing those hips forward right here. I'll stay here with you guys. That leg, hold, and then slide it up, press it up, let's take a deep breath in, exhale, one more time in, and exhale, you guys are all done, fantastic work today guys, fantastic all week, thank you so much for joining me, here in person and at home, remember at home or in person, if you enjoyed this workout, you can save and share it on Facebook, come back to this page and do it anytime you'd like, I will be back on Monday virtually at 10 o'clock. Enjoy the rest of your weekend and thank you for coming guys. Bye.